So just to introduce the geological influences on terroir development, of course I have to summarize the main factors influencing the characteristics of wine through the terroir. You know that variety is very important, climate is important, and now bedrock geology and the corresponding soil. I will underline corresponding soil with through depth, structure, chemistry, microorganism, then soil hydrology. It means a texture, and so water drainage and water reservoir. And then geomorphology, vineyard management, combining tradition and innovation, and then winemaking process. Moving to geological, it's clear the wine quality is the result of a complex of interaction. So the geology of the soil, the soil panel material has roughly three origins. The first one is a volcanic origin from the cooling of the magma, and if the cooling occurred outside or inside of the earth, we have granite or basalt. Then we have sedimentary soil, sedimentary rocks and soil, where the transport, mixing, and deposition of the material on the sea bottom or in surface it happened through erosion, gravity, wind, and so on. The last one is metamorphic rocks inside of the earth crust due to the high temperature of pressure. But when we speak about the vineyard, we know that the roots of the vine are not in the parent rocks, not altered parent rocks, but the roots are in soil or surfacing rocks, or even sometimes in parent rocks altered, but not in parent rocks not altered. So usually the vine doesn't take something about water or mineral from the parent rocks. In these cases, you can see that we have 2 meters from the soil to the not altered parent rocks. Sometimes the roots doesn't reach a so deep situation. So it's clear that it's not possible to relate geologically directly to the wine quality, since it's mainly the physical and chemical properties of soil that influence the quality. So if you have geology and then soil, it's clear that in the middle we have weathering. Weathering that could give soil, different kind of soil, with different chemical properties on physical properties. So depending on the weathering, we can have different soil starting with the same geological material. And just to give you an example, this Autos, Brady, 1984. He stated that starting with the same rocks, sedimentary, metamorphic, or volcanic rocks, depending on the outside condition, arid conditions or humid condition, we can have a different way, different step, and the result is also different mineralogical characteristic. For example, starting with these rocks here, in arid condition, we have a disintegration into minerals and small rocks due to the mechanic process. But then the following step, depending, we can have a very slowly combinations, slowly or very easily disintegration. It depends on the condition, the external condition, depends on the weathering. So on the end, starting with the same rocks, we could have different type of soil. If our condition is a humid condition, we have chemical reaction, decomposition, and we obtain in quickly way stable products. There is also this slide can show you that starting with metamorphic parent material, due to the temperature, different temperature or the different pressure, the combination between pressure and temperature, we can have a different soil and the hand. It depends in this case if we have high pressure or low pressure or high temperature or low temperature. Just to give you an idea, we did this work in the middle part of Sardinian. And it was very strange, but also very often, to find in the same block, so it means the vineyard was very close to each other, but in some cases we have clay soils where shale derived soils, in another case was coarse sandy soil derived from the granite, but it was in the same places, and probably the origin was the same. The pedology told me that the origin was metamorphic origin in both cases. So depending on the soil, there is also different hydrologic characteristics, and in these cases we have also different root distribution and root density, because there is different water availability. In this case, in sandy, in clay soil, the quantity of water was very similar to the medium of the area. In this other case, you can see that the water availability was very low, less, and so with some hydric stress. It is the reason, because also the root distribution was different. But due to the different physical characteristic of the soil, we have also different grape. Here, there is the Canonau. In one case, where we don't have any water stress, we have grape with more color, with more sugar, with more structure. In the other case, we have the same variety with a different chemical composition. And so at the end, also the wine is totally different. In one case, we have wine in the clay soil, wine that's able to age in the time. In the other case, we have wine just to have a rosé wine. This is why, after our study, the cooperative that give us this program, they try to divide the grape in relation to the different soils. There is also these authors that try to explain, to divide it, white variety and red variety, telling us which kind of soil is better to obtain good wine from a white variety, and mostly he told that chalk soils, limestone soils, and marl soils are the better one to have a good wine soil, good wine red, good white wine. There is also here gravel for Sauvignon Blanc, for Semillon. There are also good situation, soil situation to have a well-grown plant. Moving to the red variety, we have a wide range of different kind of soil that can give us good results. For example, there are granite, there are limestone, there are marl, loam, and even gravel. As I showed you before, sandy soil, also for this author, are not the best to have the maximum quality in red or white variety. So I can show you some example, just to explain how important is the interaction between variety and the soil. Here is in my region, we have a big plain here, the mountain, the hill and the mountain. So there is a big plain here with alluvial deposits. In the upper part of the plain, we have gravel soil. In the lowest part of this plain, we have clay soils. So the growers, they know that if they want to have a good tokai, this variety, Barbara is only the name of the variety, not the name of the wine. You have to grow this variety in clay soils just to obtain more fineness, more persistency, more freshness, and more body. On the opposite, there is another variety, it is a local variety, Raboso, that is grown in quite a wide quantity. The situation is exactly the opposite. You have to obtain this variety in gravel soil just to have more persistency, more body, more fineness, and more tannins. So it means that we have just to look about the variety and try to compare the exact match between variety and the soil. And I have other example. For example, in Soave, where we have Garganega to obtain Soave wine. Okay, the plain and the hills are exactly divided into different kind of soil. In one case we have volcanic soil, in the other case we have calcareous soil. Here we have an example. These are vineyard in volcanic soil. In the here you are vineyard in calcareous soil. So we do some experiment, and also here you can see that calcium carbonate in calcareous soil are very high, 45-50% the total, and around 90% the activity calcareous carbonate, calcium carbonate, so the pH is around 8. In the basalt soil, you can see that calcareous is very, very low, the limestone is very low, and also the pH is a little low. Yes, also the depth is different, but when we look at the hill per vine, there is no differences. The sugar, there is no differences. Acidity is the same. We have just a little differences in aroma compound, precursor aroma compounds, monoterpenes here. There is just a little higher in calcareous soil. And then we have also just some difference in benzenoid compounds. There are just a little higher in basalts. But also you can see here the climate condition, the temperature is exactly the same in calcareous soil, in the calcareous area, and in basaltic area. Just there is a little more rainfall, 120 in calcareous soil from August to September, and 150. But when we taste the wine, it's clear that the wine obtained in basaltic soil here, it's the smell, the flavor is inside, is in ripe fruit and spicy and the tastefulness. But if you want to obtain wine with more elegance, with more flavor, fineness, lasting aroma and floral, for sure we have to move to the calcareous soil. Here we are in Prosecco area. Mostly our area, the soil condition of this area are divided in three different types of soil type. We have marl soil, we have a conglomerate soil, and we have morainic soil. In this case, due to the water holding capacity, they are totally different in three cases. We obtain three different sparkling wine. In conglomerate, we have a more fruity and a more fragrance. In the marl soil, where we don't have any hydric stress, we have more here, you can see, we have more floral, more freshness due to the more acidity. And then in morainic area, where it's very, very often, starting just in May and June, we can have some hydric stress. The composition of the wine is different. So it depends, in this case, of the water availability capacity of the soil. So, just to emphasize, the soil characters are related to geology and through weathering. This is important to remind that weathering is another fact that we have to keep in mind, are affecting wine behavior. So soil chemical property, macro and micronutrients, limestone, pH, soil physical properties, soil structure, and soil micro and macroorganisms. But geology gives us also another important opportunity, and it is to have a sort of fingerprint, a traceability of the soil. In fact, here, soil geochemical characterization adopting XRF analysis, just to quantify the quantity of aluminium, silicio, or here there is iron or calcium, it's possible to divided year after year the different origin of the soil, just to have, as I told you, a fingerprint of the soil based on the geological characteristics. But it's the same also, we are look for the ratio between the isotopes, strontium isotopes. Look here, there are three different years, 2011, 2012, and 2010. The characterization of the soil are always the same. We are able to differentiate the different origin of the soil, but also the wine, look here, the soils and the juice, the ratio of these isotopes are always the same in the soil and also in the wine. So it means that the geology gives also another opportunity to have traceability of our wine, of our products. Now I will conclude with another two aspects. Soil preparation. Soil preparation before planting could cancel the effect of soil plant material. In our area, this is a big problem because when we are doing new plantation, we try to have a very big vineyard with a constant slope, with no obstacle, and so we do this, such kind of work. So my question, are you looking for the real geology influences of wine doing this work? We are sure that doing this work is the right system to valorize the soils and the geology. So when you have such kind of situation, the roots are in difficult because you can see that the moved soil, the roots, there are no roots in this such kind of soil. In the unaltered soil, there are a lot of roots. So does it mean that also the quality of the wine are in relation with the operation that we did when we prepare our vineyard? This is Cabernet Sauvignon. It's clear that the Cabernet Sauvignon, the grape obtained in unaltered soil, give a better quality of the wine. We have the same situation. We also move through another variety. Also in this case, Prosecco is better. This line, outside line here, there is much more floral, citrus, peach apricot, pear, just to take care of the soil before we plant the vine. But we have to say so that the soil vocation is not a stable character. This is the situation. We are not renewing the soil when we move the soil so much. We are going down to the geological origin, but with not positive effect. Look at us here, it's not possible that the evolution of the soil make two layers of distinct layer. It means that here someone, they cut one layer and they put one over the other. I will finish with another aspect that is very clear to me. Geology, soil, and geomorphology give rise to the landscape. At this picture give a reason that how important is the geology also for the landscape. And you know that there is a strict relation between a landscape and perception of the quality of the wine. So we are in different places of Italy, and the geology rise also different landscape. So, in conclusion, geology plays a fundamental role in terms of physical and chemical soil properties, but weathering has an important role too, and also the soil human work has to be considered in positive and negative effect. But the effective geology valorization comes from a vine grower choices in terms of variety, soil conservation, and soil valorization. So I start looking you rocks, and I will finish showing you soils. Thank you.